welcome to Cape Rugby TV. It's of course Wednesday night, and we bring you the very best of the world of Western Province Club Rugby. Looking forward to talking to you about where we're at in the competition structures at the moment. Of course, big thanks to Hisense, our official technical partner that's come on board with Cape Rugby TV. Score energy drinks, you'll have an opportunity to win yourself a case of Score, as well as a Hisense Infinity Pulse a little bit later. And of course, Factory Shops SA mobile app, all partners to Cape Rugby TV. My guest on the show this evening, Morgan Newman. Hello, Morgs.
How's Japs? How are you doing?
I'm pretty good and enjoying rugby.
Yeah, we seasons now, we flat, we you know, we're now in the middle part of the season and things are happening, some big results over the weekend, I see, so yeah, looking forward to keep going and you know, the problem is there is a break that might just hamper our progress, but nonetheless, good run of fixtures coming up.
Yeah, Jerome Paarwater, Head of Talent Identification at Western Province Rugby and of course involved with several other things. Hello Jerome, how are you?
Very good, JP, very busy at the moment, busy with the Craven Week trials, we had lots of trials. We had a few weeks ago, we had under 19 trials at UWC. So it's just trials and trials in rugby, and we almost busy finalizing the emerging squad. So yeah, lots of things going on.
Yeah, you know, just when people think that there might not be any rugby, I mean, just remind you folks that even though there will be a break, the rugby continues. There'll be lots of teams playing catch-up games. Still, a lot of the lower leagues will be playing their leagues during this so-called break. We've still got to work out what this break is. And many clubs are playing catch-up games and still enjoying rugby. So, in theory, yes, there is a break for some clubs, but there's not a break for all clubs, and there's certainly no break from rugby. And as you heard Jerome talk earlier on about the fact that there are trials at the moment, a little bit later in the show, we'll tell you about what's happening at the Best Med Western Province Rugby School of Excellence, where they are, of course, in the trials phase at the moment. We'll catch up with that a little bit later. Last week, on Saturday, we went to go and see two universities, UWC against UCT. Of course, iconic match, if you want to call it that, where two varsities come up against each other. And I think this is a case where you have, shall we call it, a equal playing field, where it's universities. So we'll talk more about that a little bit later in the show. But let's, for now, check out the highlights. UWC against UCT at the Mile. We'll be right back. Right, folks, we're not going to give you the result yet, but suffice to say it's going to be an interesting discussion. That was the first half. Morgs, your gut feel on the first half there?
Yeah, it's nice to see UWC really producing some good rugby. You know, in the past, they've always been a team that we speak about that you know, have the talent there but don't perform. And by the looks of that first half, there was some seriously good rugby being played. Dubious decisions again. Yeah, we know that these are, you know, but on tape, obviously, it's easy to see. But yeah, good rugby, I think, you know, to go down to the Green Mile and produce that kind of rugby is not easy because, you know, the conditions there are really tough.
Yeah. Jerome?
Yeah, it was a great game, JP. A great game to watch. You know, UCT is known for running rugby. UWC also on the day. And they were not scared to run. And for me, I don't know when last I was at UCT without any wind. So it was a nice day, Saturday there. And I mean, the conditions suit the type of rugby that they wanted to play.
All right. Well, we'll take a look at the second half and then we'll start getting into some of the match analysis. Let's check it out. There we go, folks. So the final result there, UWC 29-14 over UCT. An iconic victory for UWC. I think it's probably the first time in history that UWC has beaten UCT. Jerome, it just goes to show the playing fields have shifted a bit. The UCT dominance, or in fact the dominance of any club in the league, is not guaranteed anymore. There is no club that you can put a finger on and say, well, these guys are guaranteed to win.
Yeah, definitely, JP. I've been around, watched three games on over the weekend. And as you say, the playing fields are level. You can't go to a field and expect that this club is going to, the clubs that normally beat the sides will going to win. So you can't say that. And I think it's a great result for UWC just to get their confidence back and just to believe that they can win because... in the varsity shield, in a couple of games in the competition so far, they just lost games because of, I think, not believing. But now, hopefully, things are changing for them. And I must say, Lionel Langenhoven in Bola is doing a great job at the moment. And a lot of those guys, or most of the guys, played in the shield with a couple of older guys in the team now.
Yeah.
So hopefully, it's
that was news to me as well. I wasn't actually aware of the fact that Lionel was coaching at UWC. Everybody puts Chester Williams' name to UWC, because he's of course the director of rugby and coaches the Varsity Cup side, and Lionel is the UWC league coach.
Yeah, they swap roles, yeah. So Lionel is taking over as the head coach, and Bola is a backline coach. And I think it's
a great system for them.
Bola Conradi, Bola Conradi, former Springbok and Western Province rugby player.
Yeah, so I think it's a great system for them. And Chester, director of rugby, behind the scenes, busy with recruiting for next season, because it's almost time to get new guys in. So that's his role now. And but I must say, it's tough luck for UCT, but I mean they've scored some great trials also.
Yeah, Morgs, if we look at some of the stats, UCT are currently eighth on the log. They've got a 29% win ratio. They'll be certain to play Super League 8 next year, but not where they want to be in terms of their historical performance being top three, top four.
Yeah, you know, I think. As bad as it may seem on the log and stuff like that, I think they are going through a massive transition phase. You know, I think they didn't do well in the they didn't do well in the Varsity Cup, and now I think they're going through a massive transition phase. Yeah. And we need to understand that yes, they'll always have depth and they'll always stay in Super League. I don't think there's ever going to be a worry of, unless you know, the other teams get seriously good or do some serious recruiting. But they'll always be up there. But I think we need to give them a year or two to find their feet again. I think they, you know, if I look at that UCT side that's playing over there, it's all students. And in the past, I mean, besides the fullback, Mark, I think it is his name, they're all students. And in the past, UCT were always strengthened in the league, because we all know there's a massive difference between Varsity Cup and the league. I mean, that's, you know, that's a given. And in the past, we used to have a lot of senior players that weren't eligible to Varsity Cup that would come and strengthen certain positions. You know, up front is a big one, we all know, but, you know, props and your front rowers are always, experience is second to none when it comes to those positions. So they were always strengthened by that. And now, yeah, there were eight injured players, first team injured players, and they never had senior players coming in to strengthen their ranks. I think they're going to go through trouble, you know. So yeah, it's important that they sort of ride this wave and do some good recruiting. And hopefully next year, they'll start to pick up a few better results. And by the third year, they should be, you know, if their coach remains the same and the core of players remain the same, then I don't see they'll have a problem.
All right, folks. A lot of folks there on UCT, but we're going to get into UWC in a second. But first, let's talk to the losing coach at UCT, Christoph Estreiser. Folks, with me now, the coach of UCT, Christoph Estreiser. Christoph, tough game in the park today.
Yeah, obviously, you know, UWC came out to play. They're desperate for the lock points. We had two convincing victories early in the season over them, so good on them. They really came out and caught us off guard, yeah, I guess.
It's been a strange season for you guys. You had Shimmy as coach during the Community Cup, at least the Varsity Cup, and then you take over. Not a lot of time to make the adjustment.
No, we had a four-day break between our Varsity Cup last match and our first league match. So, you know, and coupled with a lot of players going to Western Province and an injury list of more than 20, I actually think we did fairly well this part of the league. You know, we might have lost to Martis and Bay and so on, but they're normally a top four side. So it was all close victories. We got the bonus points from it. So, you know, probably not satisfied, but with what we had, I think we did very well. Yeah.
Now you know what you got, what to work on. But none of the sides in the league anymore a foregone conclusion. We saw this weekend as well, Durbel, SK Warmers. It was a win for SK Warmers. We've seen some big surprises, and it just goes to show that the playing field is a lot more equal than it was before.
Yeah, I think a few years ago when it was 10 sides in the league, yeah, every league match was a tight one. And then the last 2 years when they expanded the league, you had these 50-pointers and massive things. So things are, I guess, going back to normal. It's becoming a competitive league every single week. Yeah. Like you can't be complacent. You can't take an easy match. I mean, I think UWC were bottom of the log today, and you know, and look what they did. So, you know, anything is possible.
Listen, I know it's tough doing these interviews post-match, so thanks a lot. And we hope you guys enjoy the break, and we look forward to seeing
Definitely,
you guys come back.
Yeah, we'll be coming back stronger, injuries back, so we're looking forward to an unbeaten second round, yeah.
Thanks, Crystal.
Cool, thanks.
There we go. Well, there you heard Christoph Estreiser, the coach of UCT, just talking about the fact that the playing fields seem to be a little bit more level now in the leagues, and that's exactly what we were saying earlier on about the fact that the The clubs, nothing is predictable anymore. In fact, we saw a couple of big surprises over the weekend. We'll talk about that a little bit later. Let's catch up now with James Alexander. He's the UCT coach, captain.
Right, folks, it's been a sort of a intervarsity, UWC against UCT. With me is the captain of UCT, James Alexander. James, tough game today.
Yeah, obviously very disappointed. I think all credit's got to go to UWC. They played extremely well. They made it difficult for us to play our natural game and took us off our structures a bit, and we couldn't come back.
You came off a tough game against Tigerberg as well, only 3 days rest.
Yeah, well, that's no excuse. We pride ourselves on our fitness and everything. So, yeah, we had all the motivation, but it just didn't come off today.
Long break now. The guys probably looking forward to it. I mean, it's been a long season. Varsity Cup, league already.
Yeah, it's 9 weeks off. So yeah, it's a bit of pull to swallow before the long break, but hopefully it'll be give us a lot of motivation going forward, and hopefully we can finish off that second half hot with get a few wins under the belt and then get into that knockoff games.
Regardless of the result today, it still looks like there's a good vibe amongst the boys. They're enjoying rugby, they're enjoying UCT.
Yeah, I think there's always a good spirit here at the club. I think that's what it's known for, and it's no different this season. I think that's the one thing that they're keeping the motivation going with all the boys. A few drinks after that always helps to get over a disappointing loss like this one. So we're no different today.
That shows great character. So well done to you guys.
Yeah, thanks very much.
We'll leave it at that. Have a good holiday, and we'll see you guys after the break.
Thanks very much.
Nice chatting there with James Alexander. We've of course had them in the show before. They joined us not so long ago after UCT had that iconic victory at the Varsity Cup with, I think, probably what's recorded as the biggest comeback in the history of rugby. Folks, we're going to take an ad break, and when we come back, we're going to give you an opportunity to win yourself a Hisense Infinity Pulse cell phone. All you need to do is go on to Facebook and tell us who is the official technical partner to Cape Rugby TV. A little bit later, we'll also give you an opportunity to win a case of Score Energy drinks. More about that a little bit later. We'll take an ad break. We'll be back in a sec. All right, folks, welcome back. It's Cape Rugby TV. As I said earlier on, you can win yourself a Hisense Infinity Pulse cell phone. Just need to go to our Facebook page and tell us who is the official technical partner of Cape Rugby TV. You can also win yourself a 55-inch smart TV if you go into the draw there. So go on our Facebook page and tell us who is the official technical partner to Cape Rugby TV. Congratulations to last week's Hisense Infinity Pulse winner, Sean Allen, who walks away with a Hisense Infinity Pulse cell phone. Remember, folks, if you enter the competition, you go into the draw to win yourself a 55-inch Hisense smart TV. These TVs are fantastic and really, really are well worth getting into the competition for. Smart TVs are great because you've got all the Wi-Fi and the apps and so forth in the selection. Very much like the TVs we got behind us. These are, of course, 65-inch TVs. You want to get into that competition. All right, we've managed to catch up now with UWC's head coach, Lionel Langenwerfen.
Right, folks, with me now, Lionel Langenwerfen. He's a coach at UWC. Lionel, a historical win today. I mean, you guys have pulled off a big one here.
Yeah, JP. This is a lot of youngsters, students, and I just told them to have patience. And the league is tough. It's a big difference between the league and the Varsity Shield. And it's a new environment. It's a new territory for them. And we need to toughen them up. And we went back to the old school. And we create a new atmosphere at the club now for the league, and it pays off at the moment. So we didn't play bad at all in our losses previous games. Just couldn't give the knockout punch. So composure and game management was our downfall in the last three games. But today, I take my hat off to them. This away win against UCT, and it shows that we're not the bottom of the lock team at all.
The guys were saying that they really had their sights on this one. I mean, it was more than just a game. It was a game against a big university, a game from maybe historically that has been on the cards possibly for a long time.
Yeah, for a long time. And look, UCT is also going through a rebuilding phase. But still, a win is a win, and to do it here, it's magic.
Oh, Lionel, congratulations. It's a historical win for you and the boys. I think you guys should be very proud of yourself.
Thank you, JP.
Here we go.
Well, it certainly looks like UWC had UCT's number this week. Jerome, UWC have kind of enlisted quite a high rank of top coaches there. Chester, Lionel coach with you at Western Province, and like you said, Bola Conradi is there. They are getting it right.
Yeah. It took a while, but things are paying off, so it's good. It's good that things are paying off, and it's good that they can go forward. Unfortunately for them, they've got a break this week again, so they can't keep that winning momentum.
I don't know, Morgs, the inconsistency of games, the sequence of games, it makes it very, very difficult for the clubs. Changing of fixtures. I mean, we saw Durbel and Esker almost change there. In fact, folks, before we talk about the fixtures in the league, let's talk to the captain of UWC, Jose Julius.
Hi mense, saam is Jose Julius. Jose, groot oorwinning vir julle vandag. Ek dink dit is miskien die eerste keer dat EWK vir UCT geklop het.
Ja, JP, I think for us it was one of those games where we had to start from the Monday, you see. And we knew coming out here wasn't going to be easy. But we said to ourselves, listen, if you want to win UCT once in your life, this is the game that we're going to target, you see, because we knew most of the players were going to be at Western Province or somewhere else, you see. And that's why we targeted this game, and we coming here wasn't going to be easy, you see. So we still had to play out of our boots, you see, play up there.
You guys have had a good season. I mean, things going well there with Chester, finding your feet. I mean, you did reasonably well. You nearly made it into the Varsity Cup. I mean, it looks like the Gears is right. The coaching is going well. So things seem to be going well at UWC.
Yeah, I think Chester is bringing our own different vibe to UWC. He's more structured and professional. Yeah. And I think some of the players are still adapting to that. But I would like to see our university grow into that professional structure with Chester and his assistant coaches.
Yeah. Strong points in the game today?
I think for us, the lineout, we said we wanted to target their lineouts, and our rucking wasn't up to standard in the previous games. So we said we had to play to the ball today in order for us to retain that retention.
We're going to leave it at that. It looks like you got a bit of a sprained wrist there, so I'll shake your hand softly. But congratulations. Historical win. Well done.
Thanks a lot, JP.
Historical win for UWC. Well done. Congratulations. Jose Julius, Jerome apparently played for the South African under-20 side.
Yeah, and he played Western Province under-21. He played Bulls under-19. So a quality player and a very good leader.
Yeah, looks like it. All right, folks, our Evox Advanced Nutrition Man of the Match. Once a week, we look for a Man of the Match at a club game. And we, of course, get the winning team to choose their Man of the Match. In this case, it was Niaz Johnson, the UWC scrum off.
Right, folks, as you know, at every club game, we have an Evox Advanced Nutrition Man of the Match, Niaz Johnson. Now, Yaz, congratulations. You win a Evox Rapid Recovery after having a fantastic game against UWC.
Thanks.
How are you feeling about your performance today?
Yeah, I'm very proud of myself. I never knew it would be so tough. It was probably my first time playing against UCT in 2 years' time now. So I never knew it was going to be this tough. And then I just came here and gave my all.
Enjoy it, yeah. I mean, it's quite a challenge playing on the Green Mile.
Yeah, it's always a challenge, yeah. Yeah, it's always tough. Yeah. And the wind, the weather wasn't great. So yeah, I just came out and played. We played as a team and we believed. That's all that came that helped us through the game.
It did look like they had a lot of that, though. Team structure, the guys were talking. I heard them behind the poles. All the time there was talking, a lot of chaos in the team.
Yeah, that was the belief we had right through the week for training. We tend to build that belief.
Yeah.
So we don't give up, because we tend to give up in the last 10 minutes of the first half and the first minute of the second half.
Yeah.
So we bet tight. So we try to get that belief in there so we can help us through to the 80 minutes.
And then to finish it off.
Well
done. You are the Evox and Voice Nutrition Man
Thanks
of the Match.
Lot.
You walk away with that tub of Rapid Recovery. Congratulations. Go and enjoy it.
Thanks a lot.
There we go.
All right, folks, there we go. Just talking about the... let's go back to Morgs, to your discussion earlier on about inconsistencies. Extremely difficult to win games or get your team to have consistency if the environment changes. If you're changing fixtures, if you're changing the time, if you're playing catch-up games, you're just never going to get consistency in your results.
Yeah, look, I understand it's a very difficult thing to you know, with all that, with the in excess of 90 teams, it's very difficult to plan. But it, like you know, to add to what you're saying there, it is extremely difficult to plan. You know, as a team, you want to play Saturday after Saturday after Saturday after Saturday, so that you can build momentum. You know, you can pick certain fixtures to rest certain players. You can, you know, manage your side. You can prepare certain ways. You know, you can do the homework in the background.
So the reason why I'm laughing, I was at UCT on Saturday. And an old guy, he came up, I think it was about 4:15. I was, he asked...
is this the second team?
What's going on here? Yeah, but he said, like you say, he said there's a lot of those guys are playing first team.
Yeah.
Why are they playing those? He said, it is the first team.
It is the first team. Well, the kickoff at 2:30. So I was in George for a function, and I landed at 2:00. Quickly went home to change and maybe just relax a little bit. And I started looking through the Twitter feeds, the hashtag, we follow the hashtag WP Club Rugby, look at the scores. And at 3:00, I saw the score coming in at 7-7 for UCT versus UWC. And I thought, how's it 7-7? This must be the second team at 3:00. And then I realized, no, something is wrong here. The time they kicked off early. And if I didn't pick it up on Twitter, I would have missed the game myself. I raced up, managed to get to UCT, UWC for the second half of the game. But even myself wasn't aware of the fact that the fixture had changed to 2:30.
And you know what, JP, what's so sad for this old guy? Because he said he hardly
missed a game
at UCT. And he's a really old guy, and he was quite upset, and also to see the score at that time, he couldn't believe it. So everything, I just hope that guy's still alive, because he was very upset.
We're going to take an ad break. When we come back, we'll take a look at the rest of the results, and I'll tell you, there's going to be a couple of surprise results for you from this weekend. Welcome back, everybody. Yes, Cape Rugby TV, here it is. Remember, you can find us on Facebook, www.facebook.com/CapeRugbyTV. Score energy drinks, of course, partner to Cape Rugby TV, also sponsor of the West Bromwich Sevens that's coming up later in the year. If you want to win yourself a case of Score energy drinks, then all you need to do is SMS the word SCORE to 33280, 33280. And congratulations to last week's Score winner, Michelle Marsden, a big fan of Western Province Rugby, big fan of Cape Rugby TV. Michelle, you walk away with a case of Score energy drinks, 24 energy drinks on its way to you, at least ready for collection. And Michelle, incidentally, I've seen her on Facebook, has helped us with the looking for tackies. We're looking for tackies and sneakers for kids. We know that many of you out there have got some kids that have outgrown their tackies. If you've got a spare pair of tackies, please go onto our Facebook page and help us source these tackies. Clubs out there, ask your moms and dads, or at least have a look in the cupboard and see if you've got a pair of old tackies, secondhand tackies. In fact, we're also going to get onto rugby boots drive. We've got kids out there at the moment that need rugby togs. All right, folks, let's take a look now at the results in Super League A. Eh? Primrose, 24-18 over NNK. False Bay went 30-20 over Tigerberg. Hamilton's beating Belhar by 3 points, 22-19. SK Warmers beat Durbel 19-12. UCT, of course, went down to UWC. And then Kales River lost to Brackenfell 22-20. Jerome, a couple of surprise results here. Primrose has been strong. They haven't had a 100% success rate. At the moment, they're sitting on a 29% win ratio with an average scoring of 18 points per game. But they are playing good enough to be 9 on the log and still go out there and beat NNK.
Yeah, definitely, JP. They have a better season than last year, and with the new coach, Mpo Mbuyozo there. So he's doing something right there, and I've watched a couple of their games. There's a great spirit there, and also they believe that they can do well and they can play. And so I must take my head off for Mpo turning the club around there.
Okay, let's look at some other stats here. False Bay are at the moment sitting on scoring 34 points on average per game. They played 7 games already. They got 100% success ratio. Tigerberg, 38 points average per game, and are sitting on a 71% success ratio. They've scored 266 points this season, and False Bay 238. Yet False Bay are still proving to be the team to beat this year.
Yeah, definitely, JP. If you just look at the points there, then False Bay is winning, but the other teams are scoring more tries than them. So it's quite interesting.
Yeah, it's interesting stats that they haven't got that many points. Morgs Hamilton's, you guys played against Balhar over the weekend, and by all accounts, it looks like it was a tough game. 3 points.
Yeah, it's a very good Balhar side, you know, I must say. I mean, Balhar came out and they played good rugby. We went in the lead quite early and, thought it might be a comfortable day in the park, but Balhar bounced back and played some really good rugby, and in the end, a lot closer than we would have liked. But yeah, I mean, you know, if it wasn't for the wing on the day, Earl Lewis to have kicked, two massive kicks from the touchline for us to win that game, then we would have been in some trouble. So very good Balhar side, and I see them picking up or really beating one or two of the top sides, or they're putting more performances like that.
Hamilton's still has a game in hand in comparison to False Bay, who's played 7. Hamilton's False Bay top of the log. Not this weekend, but next weekend it's going to be a monster game. False Bay, you guys are you targeting that as a win?
Yes, I tell you what, we target the next 3 weeks are big for us. You know, Tigerberg, we've seen the massive performances Tigerberg put in. We play them this weekend, so we're looking no further than this weekend. You don't want to look too far away. You know, we've seen what the likes of UWC have done to UCT now. And we can take lessons from that, you know. I think we'll look to work towards Tigerberg this week, and then once that result's out of the way, we'll look at the following week. So not taking any team lightly, and I'm sure it'll be a tough weekend, and you know, for us as well as Tigerberg, False Bay also have big games coming up. So yeah, I think we'll see a few teams move up and down in the log over the next few weeks.
It's interesting that we talk about teams moving up and down. SK Women's played against Durbel over the weekend. A lot of people, Jerome, said that Durbel are consistent. We spoke about this. They're consistent, and they play consistent rugby. And that the tip was going in SK in Durbel's favour. SK Women's came out and they proved many people wrong.
Yeah, definitely, JP. And Durbel is currently the club champs in SA, so it's a big win for SK also there. And I must say also, we always spoke about the conditioning. And you can just see that the SK guys are fit, they condition, and they just play rugby, and they played on the day they played great rugby, scored some great tries, and their forwards were actually the guys who met up to Durbel and gave them a really hard run for their money. And Madig David's there, leading from the front there. And Denville Erasmus playing very well. Johnson, the one winger, the fullback was good. But just a great performance on the day.
The other game that also a lot of people said it was going to be a possible win for Kalesriver, Brackenfell. Kalesriver have proven to be a strong side. They had a very good Super League A. Didn't go their way though.
Yeah, JP, it's just sad to see that, Kalesriver is a great club, and it's sad to see that things are not working for them. And I mean, they had very high expectations of this season. Last year, the way everybody was talking, and we all expect them to do much better. And there's a few problems there that they need to sort out.
Right, so that's a win then for Brackenfell over Kalesriver, 22 points to 20. And if we just look at some of the success ratios there, Brackenfell at the moment are sitting on a 43% win ratio, and Kalesriver on a 17% ratio. Brackenfell scoring on average 20 points per game, and Kalesriver 23 points per game. So if they look at the stats, according to the stats, this should have been a Kalesriver win. Perhaps just a slip there, and it sounded like it was a pretty tight game, 22-20 in favour of Brackenfell. Let's take a look at Super League A B's results now. Violets went down by 1 point to Hamlets. Collegians beating St George's 14-13. It was a massive win for Union Mill, 75-29 over Strand. Helderberg went down to Villagers by 1 point, and then Goodwood, 55-27 over Macassar. In Super League C, it was Blue Jets with a win over Strand United. Franschhoek United beat Paarl 30-23, and Silverleaf went down to Rangers 35 points to 3. In the City League, Manenberg Rangers beat Temperance 26-12, Busy Bees with a win over Caledonia Roses, and Perseverance losing to Progress 24-7. In the Southern League, it was two matches with Eersterivier beating Peninsula and Titans going up over Young Brothers. The Northern League also two matches, Vineyards 55-8 over Van Estel, and a big win for Blue Stars as they beat Strand Pioneers 59-24. And in the Paar League, we had three games with a win for Violets Paar over Young Standards, Lower Paar beating Albion's 31-0, and Young Gardens 45-18 over Peril United. All right, folks, we're going to take an ad break, and when we come back from the ad break, we're going to take a look at what happened at the trials, the West Bromwich Rugby Trials. The juniors were in action yesterday, and we'll introduce you to the best med Western Province Rugby School of Excellence. Back in a sec. Welcome back, everybody. Right, don't forget you must download the Factory Shops SA mobile app. Grab your Android or Apple phone and download the Factory Shops SA mobile app. If you want to find any factory shop or discount store close to you for any type of item that you're looking for, you simply download the app, and in the app type in the type of product that you're looking for, and it'll immediately find the different stores that are listed and the store nearest to you. And then on top of that, it gives you the GPS location. So once you push that button, it'll take you via Google Maps straight to the store that you're looking for, and route you all the way there and walk in and buy your product at that special price. So Factory Shops SA mobile app, do a search for it on the Google Play Store or on the iTunes Store and download the Factory Shops SA mobile app. They of course have come on board with Cape Rugby TV and are now a supporting partner to Cape Rugby TV. Right, folks, we went out yesterday to the trials, the Western Province Rugby Trials, where of course the best med Western Province Rugby School of Excellence is taking part. Let's go and see what happened out there.
The following Western Province Rugby School of Excellence insert is brought to you by BestMed. Be active, be safe, be happy, be NutriWise, be FinFit.
It's our fourth round of trials, Western Province trials against Willand today. So everybody that's gone sort of through the system and through the trial process now today getting their final opportunity to prove their worth.
Today we have the Western Province under 16 trials against Boland, which is very entertaining because you get to see who has a making for it and who hasn't. I know some of the guys, they go into their shell, the rest of them, they come out and they expose themselves and their true talents. This is a big stepping stone because most of these kids don't make it to Province Under 13. So this is just another door for them which they can open and secure future for them, because obviously we're looking for kids who can make it to Under 18, then go through Under 19 and filter through to the Currie Cup ranks.
Got to play hard, more physical. People, like, guys want to show each individual player, want to show what he's got. So, yeah, it's a tough game out there. In the Oaks have been in the elite squad. We've been training since February. So, yeah, we've been putting a lot of work in up till now.
We practiced for about 6 weeks every Wednesday, and now we're playing against Boland on our last trials. And then hopefully we'll hear from now on if we're through to the next rounds.
Ja, ik is het goed. De eerste twee games was een beetje paar fouten geweest en zo, maar ik denk die laatste game wat nu bezig is, speelt goede rugby en daar komt goede individuen wat de handen opsteek. We hebben helpen jonge spelers. Je weet Wolfert en Jerome is betrokken also. Je weet, en alle kijken naar die jonge ouwkies. Vooral Wolfert bij de onder 16 ja, identificeren en dan opbrengen samen met hem naar die onder 18 groep.
It was a very successful day. We had three games, and most of our top players were playing in these games. So we've got a good idea with the guys that's going to make it for the two teams. From here, the guys are now, what's name, we're going to the Coastal Tournament in Oudtshoorn. where there will be two games. We will have two teams participating, and out of that we'll be able to say who's the A team, who's the province under 16A and the 16B team that's going to participate in the Grand Como.
It's a great day. We have three under 16 teams playing, as well as three under 18 teams. It's the cream of the crop in Western Province being here today, so we are happy with what's happening here. It's a great having this relationship with Bestman.
Everybody, yes, looks like there are lots of activity. Jerome, tell us a little bit more about the trials for the kids. How does it work?
Yeah, JP, we started off about a month and a half ago with the sort of the schools who are not playing in the top league. So we had it was on a holiday day. We had a whole day of trials for them, and out of them we picked a side, and then from there they were sort of in the mainstream. And then we had our trials at City Park, where those guys were in, and the best out of that guys are still in the structures now in the trials, and then we had our final trials is this week, and now we're selecting three sides who's going to the coastal tournament up in Oudtshoorn. And then from there, the final, which is an academy under 18 team and a Cravenwick team. So we select 46 players to go on that coastal. And then on that coastal, we announce the final squads for the academy and the Cravenwick side.
All right, so it looks like there certainly looks like a bunch of quality players there, very, very big boys as well. The kids seem to be getting bigger and bigger. Next week, folks, we'll take another look at the Best Med Western Province Rugby School of Excellence and take a look at how the kids get into that School of Excellence and some of the, call it the pillars of strength of the Best Med Western Province Rugby School of Excellence. Let's take a look at some of the Western Province Rugby Club Rugby fixtures coming up over the weekend. It's Durbel up against NNK on Friday night, Brackenfell and Solarians on also on Friday night, then Tigerberg and Hamilton's on Saturday, and Primrose and False Bay on Saturday. Kickoff at 4 o'clock, provided the fixtures don't change. On in Super League B, it's Young Peoples and Kraaifontein, Villages Collegians, Peniel Villages and Macassar, Violets and Strand, Hands and Hearts and Helderberg, and Belleville and Hamlets. In Super League C, Young Stars and Langa, Strand United and Elsie, Silverleaf, Masipumulele, Scottsdene and Rangers, Kylemore and Hamadiers, Franschhoek take on Raithby, and Blue Jets are up against Lagunya. Temperance and Cities are up against Caledonian Roses at City Park, Silvertree take on the Western Zebras, the fixture still to be confirmed, Police in Progress, Manenberg Rangers and Young Ideas, Busy Bees are up against Watsonia at the Langa Stadium. In the Southern League, it's Young Wesleys and Thistles, Young Brothers Retreat, Peninsula Richmond Rangers, Noordlikers and Eerste Rivier, and Bishop Labours take on Titans. While in the Northern League, it's Stelkor up against Whistling Wheels, Imikawi take on Vineyards, Delft take on Atlantis, Blue Stars United up against Van der Stel, Blake's take on Strand Pioneers, and All Saints are up against Khayelitsha. While in the Paarl League, we see Young Standards and Windmill United, Simondium and Violets Paarl, Riverstones and Peril United, Paarl Rangers are up against Young Gardens, and Albions are up against Allendale. Let's quickly take a look at some of those fixtures then, folks. The opportunity there for some of the clubs, Jerome, to get back into the mix. If we look at those fixtures there, Durbel, NNK. NNK are currently bottom of the log. They're not doing fantastic. They're scoring on average 15 points per game. They've had a 0% success rate, and basically they haven't won any games. Whereas Durbel, they come off a shock loss to SK Warmers. I mean, if we're going to again predict it on paper, this should be a win for Durbel.
Yeah, definitely, and also at Durbel, you don't go there and just easily take points there. But I just hope that NNK can do a little bit better because it can determine their season.
Morgs, Brackenfell take on Solarians this week. Home ground advantage for Brackenfell. They are also doing pretty well. They came off a strong win now against Kales River. Solarians not doing all that great. They've only won one out of their six games. Again, if we're looking at it on paper, this should be a Brackenfell win.
Yeah, I think, you know, these teams target one another. You know, I think Solarians will target Brackenfell and Brackenfell will target Solarians. So, yeah. But as you discussed a few weeks back, and I think to stay up in Super League A, I think you need to win about four games. And if you look at Brackenfell, they've now won 3 games. Mm. So I think one more victory for them will almost, in essence, secure their stay in Super League A for another year. And Solarians have only won 1 game this year so far. Need to start picking up results in order to stay up. So, like I said, these two teams target one another, and it'll be interesting fixtures to go and watch. I wouldn't... Brackenfell are strong and they're playing good rugby, but I wouldn't write Solarians off. But I would, yeah. Very few games.
This is a game that... Paper doesn't count. It can go anywhere. It can be a win for SK. It can be a win for Brackenfell. The 100%. Other big fixture we've got then is Tigerberg Hamilton's. Morgs, I'm going to throw this one in your corner. You said earlier on, Tigerberg, you can't predict it. You're playing away. Hamilton's playing away to Tigerberg. It's going to be tough.
Yeah, it's never easy at the cage. We know what kind of crowds they attract. So, yeah, we've done our homework, and I'm sure that it'll be a tough game. Near the top three, so top of the table clash. And Tigerberg are playing really good rugby. Hamilton's come off an average result against Bahar. So, we need to back to the drawing board and put in some hard work. And then I'm sure we'll see a good fixture on Saturday.
Jerome Primrose are up against False Bay. False Bay top the log at the moment. It's going to be a tough match for Primrose.
Yeah, I think Primrose will be competitive. But I think False Bay might be a little bit too strong.
Well, Primrose at the moment sitting on played 7. They've won 2 of their 7 matches, but nevertheless still sitting number 9 on the log. All right, folks, let's take a look at Super Brew. As you know, our Super Brew competition keeps on running weekly. We're having a lot of fun out there, and certainly interesting to see how the predictions go. Top 10 in Super Brew at the moment. Pune is sitting at number 1. Boston, P Bull jumped up 6 places. Into 3rd place, Jacques Krill, Joey, Chelly Boy, Executioner, Dan the Man, Ashley goes down 3, and Will I Am sits at number 10 on the log. All right, so it certainly looks like there's a lot of fun on in the Super Brew side. So some interesting fixtures then coming up also in Super League B. Let's just touch on the Super League B fixtures before we leave you alone. Young People's Kraaifontein, Villages Collegians, Penino Villages and Macassar, Violence and the Strand, Hands and Hearts, Helderberg and Belleville and Hamlets. All right, so Hamlets are currently sitting on top of the log there. They are up against Belleville. Belleville sitting at number 5 on the log. Jerome, Belleville and Hamlets, this is going to be a good game in Super League B.
Yeah, definitely. You know, Belleville's got two games still in hand, which they need, and they're pretty much okay where they are now. So I think this weekend will be lots of running rugby at Belleville, so it'll be a good game to watch.
Possibly the fixture to keep an eye on in Super League B, Belleville Hamlets.
Yeah, definitely. And I know the Hamlets will bring about 3 buses.
Yeah.
Belleville will have 2,000 people there. So be a lot of people there at the game.
It's going to be a lot of fun then, folks. Go check out Belleville Hamlets. That looks like the one of the pick of the week, so to speak, in Super League B. Morgan Newman, thanks for joining me on Cape Rugby TV. We'll hopefully get you back on the show next week or sooner than that.
Always good to be here, Jeff. Thanks for having me.
Lekker. Jerome, best of luck with the trials. I know that the Best Med School of Excellence is up and running and having a lot of fun.
Yeah, JP. Lots of talent out there. It's difficult. It's tough. But hopefully we'll get to the right guys.
Yeah. Right, folks. That's a wrap from Cape Rugby TV. To all our partners, Evox, Score, Hisense, and of course, Mobile. Factory Shops SA Mobile app. Thanks for joining us. And thanks to Best Med also for coming on board now with Cape Rugby TV. Best Med, Western Province Rugby School of Excellence. Remember, you can find us on Facebook, and don't forget to tweet over the weekend. Keep those scores coming in. We always want to see where you are and what you're doing. We'll see you again next week. Same time, same place. Have a fantastic rugby weekend. Bye-bye.